Hi Tim, thank you for the time as always. How did your camp go at Team Renegade? And is Leon going to be there on fight night to support yourself and Fabian?
Hi guys. The camp went very well, thank you. The work that we putting in at Renegade is unmatched, I believe. And yeah, Leon will be there cornering me. I'm lucky to have him as my head corner, and he'll be doing his brother as well. So yeah, we've got a great little team over at Renegade.
Can you talk a little bit more about your camp and the energy in the gym? Because Leon, of course, brought the belt there, defended the belt there. I mean, the gym is probably at an all-time high, right?
Yeah, absolutely. The energy in the gym is unreal. Like, with him defending it as well now, solidifying his spot as the king of the welterweight, so the best in the world, potentially best welterweight in the world. It re really brings a big energy to the gym. We all kind of feed off of that energy. We all work, us high level pros all work together to build each other. And yeah, it just helps with our performances ourselves as well, So we're very lucky to have him train with us, mentor us, and coach us and guide us.
What do you make of Chris as an opponent? I mean, he only lost to the very elite competition in this division, and he seems to be in exciting fights always. He also was previously ranked. Did all of this motivate you a lot to fight him?
Yeah, absolutely. I didn't know he was ranked previously, but that's yeah, interesting to know. I obviously knew he's up there ranked. He's a highly touted fighter, Bellator like him. Yeah, his losses have been to high level guys. I think he's 8-2, so he's had 10 fights. Nurmagomedov was one loss, and
Yamauchi.
Yamaguchi. Not again, yeah, and they're both very, very, they're veterans of the sport. And I know obviously Nurmagomedov is like young and he's the champion, and he tried the team that he comes from. So Chris, he's an exciting fighter, he's an exceptional athlete. He's achieved a lot in his wrestling, but this is MMA, and I'm excited to step in there with him, and no doubt he is with me because, as everyone knows, I'm always in an exciting fight too.
Exactly. And it's been 4 years since Bellator visited Birmingham. And that show was absolutely magnificent and a big success for the city of Birmingham. And with all the success Team Renegade has right now, do you think, Tim, a return to Birmingham is inevitable?
I think so. I think, just me and Fabian alone, with Fabian on his trajectory, when he gets a win Friday night, maybe when he wins that belt at the end of the year, he can defend it first time in Birmingham. I like to think that a big win for me Friday night will push me into the top 10. I don't wish injury on anyone, but I'm ready to step into the tournament if anybody gets injured. So yeah, I think like Birmingham, as you said, with the hype around Birmingham and UK MMA, why not? I'm sure Bellator will definitely be up for the idea.
Always nice to talk to you, Tim. Cannot wait to see you perform again. Good luck on fight night, sir.
Thank you.
Sun made.
Yes, Tim, it's good to talk to you, sir. Hard fight victory against Saul last year, last October. It was a great performance by yourself. Is there been anything in particular that you've been working on for this fight?
Hi, mate. So thank you for that. Yeah, it was probably my best performance today against a serious competitor in Saul. To be honest, I took a couple of weeks off after that fight, got a little cut up. It was a hard fight, rested, and then I just got back to work with the team. I went out to Thailand for some training, come back. Leon and Joy Herbert were in camp. I was with them. Arnold Allen was in camp. I was with them. We're all just working really hard down at Team Renegade. We've got amazing coaches and training partners around us. Like, I really do think we're doing it the best in UK, if not Europe. And yeah, as regards to the camp, it hasn't really changed too much. It's similar in ways to Saul, and I'll just be looking to build off of the back of that performance.
Nice, and my colleague actually caught you at UFC 286 outside the arena. But it's good that you guys in Team Renegade look after one another. Are you going to be putting in work as well for Jai's upcoming performance in UFC in June?
Yeah, that's it. You know, I don't like to look past the fight because, you know, you can pick up injuries and stuff. That's natural. But yeah, Jai will want me to work with him, no doubt, for July. But our weight categories, you know, like featherweight, lightweight, welterweight, middleweight, it's just stacked. The gym is just full of bodies, high level, all shapes and sizes, all different backgrounds. And yeah, we've all got the same mindset. It's just in every day, work hard, but work smart, you know. We don't hurt each other. We just build each other.
Nice. We've seen on your socials as well. You've introduced the Tim Wilde's thoughts for the day. We've already enjoyed that, by the way. Does that show a change in your mentality? Are you maybe taking a step back and really mulling over things, mulling how your day's gone, or how's that impacted you?
Yeah, you know, like, thanks for noticing that and thanks for liking it. A lot of people are liking it, actually, weirdly. It was a shout out to the missus. It was an idea from her. She was like, yeah, just because, you know, I'm a little bit older, as we know. I'm 36 this year. This social media kind of age, I'm a little bit behind that. I call myself a dinosaur. I know I'm not. There's people, you know, worse, but... she said, like, you should start putting your morning thoughts on, and I did, and it took off. People are enjoying it. But yeah, you know, like, I'm a deep thinker. I have a lot of time reflecting, a lot of time studying fights, a lot of time studying myself and thinking about myself. I think that just comes with age anyway, but I'm just not very good at portraying it across on social media, so I just let my fighting do the talking. You know, I'm not one here to stop bad-mouthing fighters or trying, you know, doing things for likes. I just get in there, I fight hard, I fight entertaining, and I'm always exciting. And I hope that that'll just give me the kind of push that I need to get me in top 10 and get me to somewhere where I can earn a shot at the title.
Nice. And how do you visualize this fight going? What's your prediction?
The first round is going to determine the way the fight goes. I think he's going to try and come out hard and strong. I think he's going to struggle with my striking and my kind of footwork and the way I move. I think he perhaps will think he knows how I do, but then, like, I see it with everyone when they get in there. I'm very hard to imitate. I move different. And I think he'll perhaps try to strike with me for the first round. I mean, he might sneak an entry or a takedown if he can in the first, but I think following that, I would see him look to perhaps naturally go back to his instincts to wrestle a bit more. Where I'm going to shut that down as well. So, okay, he's tough. He's very tough. I mean, he has been stopped before, but so have I. You know, everybody gets stopped, but he's tough. He's a competitor. He's an athlete, and he's going to come to win. So, it could potentially go the distance, but regardless of whether it goes the distance, or it's stopped, it'll be my hand that's being raised.
Nice. And then the last one from me, Tim, obviously you're unbeaten in four now, but does it feel good not fighting another Englishman?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, you know, there's a lot of people in the Bellator lightweight division that aren't English. I'd rather fight those guys, you know what I mean? Since Saul yesterday was training with him, it's nice to talk to him and not have to, like, hate him in my head mentally to fight him. Do you know what I mean? So I think, like, I truly believe I'm leading from the front with the English guys, you know. I'm number one in England. I want to be number one in Europe, and I'm going to keep pushing. So for me, give me the Europeans and give me the Americans and let me show what I can do. Push myself up them rankings.
Cheers, Tim. All the best for Friday.
Thanks a lot, man. Hold on. Thank you very much.